Hey guys, it's Jake, and welcome back to day two of learning to program in Ruby. I hope you enjoyed the first lesson, and if you haven't already, please just go ahead and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any of the next lessons. Okay, go ahead and open Komodo Editor. Once you have that open, go to File and select New, ruby.rb. Today we're going to be going over arithmetic operators. So go into your editor and type in puts 6 plus 11. Go up to File, Save As, type in addition .rb. Then go to Start Command Prompt with Ruby from your Start menu. And pull in, where's that? Addition. Drop that in and hit Enter. And it outputs 17. So what it's done is it said, you've told Ruby to put out, print or puts, 6 plus 11, and it gives you back 17. Okay, and then this is pretty straightforward with all of the other commands until we get to the last two. So let's just quickly do the other ones real fast. So come back into your Komodo editor, and on the next line, put puts. Let's do 20 minus 10. And then let's do multiply 5, shift 8, which is star. Where is my cursor? There you are. Puts, let's do 8, shift for star, which is times, 10. Enter, puts. Let's do 100 divided by forward slash, same thing, 10. And then these two are the ones that are a little tricky. So an exponential is just going to be the how many times it's going to be multiplied by itself. So to make it easy, we're just going to do puts 10 exponential 4. And so let's save it right there, and we'll go over Modulo a little bit later. Just hit Save. Go back to your Ruby console. Pull in the new file, addition. Okay. So, we've told it to put 6 plus 11 is 17, puts 20 minus 10, and it put 10, puts 8 times 10, and it put 80, then puts 100 divided by 10 is 10 right here, and then we told it to put 10 exponential 4, and we have 10,000 here. And how we got 10,000 was what we did right over here. You can see we did 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. So that's the exponential. So 10 times 10 would be 100. 100 times 10 is 1,000. And 1,000 times 10 is 10,000. So that's what that is. Let's go right back in. And we're going to be going over modulo. So puts, let's do 15 modulo, which is the percentage sign, and let's choose 4. Go ahead and hit File. Save. It doesn't really matter. You can have it right up here, you can have a line skipped. It's not going to matter to Ruby, but just go ahead and hit File, Save. Pull that in. Hit Enter. And it's returned 3. So what happened here? It says right here, 10, or puts 10 exponential 4s, the 10,000, and then the next line was 15 modulo 4. So let me just explain it over here on the notepad a bit. Modulo returns whatever the remainder is in a divided number. So what it does is it takes 15 and it divides it by 4, and 4 goes into 15 3 full times. But that's not what it's returning. I probably should have picked a better number. That's not what it's returning. What it's returning is what's left over, because 4 can go into 15 3 times and that would equal 12, and then there's 3 remaining that it doesn't fully go into. So 3 is what it returns. So let's come back in here to show you another example. And let's change this to, let's change it to 17. And then hit File, Save. Let's pull it back in. You see here now that it returned a 1 instead of a 3. And that's because 4 goes into 17 4 full times, because 4 times 4 is 16. And the remainder is 1. So what it's returned is the remainder number. And you might think, okay, why is this useful? Actually, it's extremely useful in any coding. So that is why I'm showing you it now, but trust me, you're going to use it a lot more than you think. Okay, so I hope that was a really good overview of arithmetic in Ruby. We're going to be going over some more stuff tomorrow, but if you haven't already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. I'm also going to put some links to some books, some Ruby coding books on Amazon, so you can go down there and click on those and look at those. Those are full breadth, like goes over everything, you can know everything about, you know, pretty much like what we talked about in the first episode, where if you want to make $100,000 a year, that book is going to have everything you need. Those books are going to have everything you need. I'm going to put multiple books in there so you have options. But yeah, just keep pressing forward with the videos, and we'll talk to you later.